Hi, my name is Jeffrey Custis. I'm a technology officer at ITQ. I have with me today Victor van den Berg, VMware SE. Welcome, Victor.
Thank you, Jeffrey. Thank you for having me today.
Yeah, sure. So today we're going to talk about VMware Cloud on AWS. That's a VMware-managed cloud service running an SDDC inside an AWS data center.
Exactly.
We're going to talk about networking today. There's been quite some updates there, right?
Yeah, that's correct, Jeffrey. Since a couple of months, we now offer NSXT as the software-defined network layer for VMware Cloud on AWS.
Cool.
And with this change, we also have some improvements to the architecture, the networking architecture, and there are also some new capabilities available. So I want to tell you something more about, well, actually the architecture, if we talk about VMware Cloud on AWS in relation to NSXT.
Yeah.
So
take us through it.
Yeah. So there's already some stuff here on the board. This big square here in the center, let's say that is our VMware Cloud on AWS data center. So this is the place where our virtual machines will be running, and also our management components such as the vCenter server, NSX server, and ESX iHost will run here on the VMware Cloud on AWS. Yeah.
So this is where your SDDC lives.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, of course, we have to deal with internet. Probably we want to have some kind of connectivity to the internet.
Yeah.
Maybe we are also running an on-premises data center.
Yeah, will be in most cases, I guess.
Yeah. Software-defined data center, private cloud. And we also have a connection, or we can also use our AWS VPC, virtual private cloud. And in our VPC, we will run our native AWS services.
Okay, stuff like S3, RDS, that's living there.
Exactly, okay. Exactly. So the question is, how can we connect all these components?
Yeah.
So first of all, let's get some extra details in our VMware Cloud.
Yeah.
So of course, we have our virtual machines running here. And these are actually our, the customer virtual machines, so the customer workloads.
Yeah, running the apps.
Running the apps.
Okay.
Those are running in our VMware Cloud.
Yeah.
Next to that, we have our management components. For example, your vCenter server.
Yeah.
But also the NSX manager. And of course, we need our ESX iHosts. VMware Cloud on AWS, the minimum configuration is 3 ESX iHosts.
Okay.
So, that is the first part, the first components we need here in VMware Cloud on AWS. So the question is, how can we connect these virtual machines together? How can we have access to the management components? And how can we access the internet or make a connection to the software-defined data center on-premises or maybe consume the services?
Yeah.
So what we have here on top of this diagram is our internet gateway. And this component is responsible for the connectivity to the internet.
Is that an NSXT component or is it a...
That is actually an AWS component.
A native construct.
Yeah, a native construct, but we will connect it to NSX later on.
Okay.
So for our SDDC connection, or the connection to our SDDC, we can use VPN, and or we can use AWS Direct Connect. That's over here.
Okay.
And for that, we need what they call, or what Amazon calls, a virtual private gateway.
Okay. And this could be layer 2, layer 3?
If we talk about the connection between the VMC data center and on-premises, we can do that routed, layer 3, or we can even stretch networks from our data center to on-premises.
Okay, cool.
That's both possible. The last part, the VPC, we need a VPC router for that. So that's down here, the VPC router. And now the question is, how can we connect all these different parts to the workloads we have running here in VMC?
Okay.
So, with the introduction of NSXT, we can now leverage the multi-tier routing model that NSXT provides.
Yeah.
So we will start with drawing what we call a T0 router. And this T0 router is actually the foundation for from a networking perspective of our environment.
That's kind of like a provider router, right?
You can call it a provider router, that's correct. And this T0 router connects to the internet gateway here, to the virtual gateway there, and also to the VPC router there. But we still haven't got connectivity to our virtual machines or to our management components. So to provide that specific connectivity, we will implement two additional, what we call T1 routers. And we have one T1 router, what we call the compute gateway. And we have a second router, what we call the management gateway. And these two T1 routers are both connected to the T0 router on the left or on the right.
Yeah.
These routers are made available by VMware, so it's all pre-configured.
Okay, so I don't have to deploy these routers myself, I don't need to configure them?
No, this is part of the service.
Okay, cool.
You have to do some configuration, for example, for the T1 router. You are able, as a consumer, to deploy what we call segments. And a segment is actually a layer 2 networking segment.
Kind of like a VLAN.
Kind of like a VLAN,
okay.
Correct.
Conceptually, yeah.
So we can deploy a segment here, and we can connect the different virtual machines to this segment. And as you can see now, we can implement the required connectivity we need.
Yeah.
If we have more VMs running here, we can choose to configure an additional segment and connect these virtual machines to this secondary segment.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So how do you deal with security in such a model?
By default you have the routing available here, but with the release of NSXT as part of VMware Cloud on AWS, we also have the distributed firewall available in VMware Cloud on AWS.
Yeah.
So we can firewall what we call east-west traffic between the VMs in the same segment, but also between the VMs across these different segments.
Okay, so you can do micro-segmentation.
VMware Cloud
That's
on AWS.
Awesome.
That's correct. Yeah. So for the management gateway, this part, we also have three segments, one for the virtual center, one for NSX, and one segment here at the bottom for your ESX IOSTs. This is all managed by VMware, and it is pre-configured as part of the service.
Okay, so I don't need to bother with managing or configuring all those networks as a customer.
That's correct. That's correct. The only thing you have to think about, for example, if you want to access your vCenter server, you have to do some initial firewall configurations so you can configure in what way you can access your virtual center server.
Yeah, because you want to prevent that everyone in your SDDC can access the management server.
Yeah, you can determine which on-premises VLAN is allowed to access the vCenter server.
Okay.
So I hope this clear-ups
Yeah, this is really good stuff. I think it makes it really clear, you know, how the multi-tiered routing in NSXT is implemented in VMC. And I have to say it looks obviously very similar to what we're doing in on-prem data centers with NSXT.
Yeah.
But that's kind of the whole point of the whole offering. So, good stuff, Victor. Thanks for explaining this.
Okay.
And thank you for watching. And be sure to stay tuned to this channel for additional videos. Thanks.